Hello everyone, this is George Gao. So here today I'm with one of my clients, Simon, who has been working with me for a while, and I wanted him to share some of what he's learning in our work together in the hopes that some of what he has experienced and is experiencing will be helpful for you all who are building your own business as well, especially if you are starting to build your new practice or you're shifting to a new modality that or framework that you're putting out into the world. So, Simon, thanks so much for doing this.
Hi. Good to see you, George.
Good to see you. So, where I'd like to start is, you know, in the sort of towards the beginning of our work, you actually went to my Joyful Productivity workshop and you found it helpful, and there were a couple of things you kind of got from there that you kind of practices that you started doing that you found helpful. So I don't know if you want to talk about a couple of those.
Yeah, no, I'd love to. And even before that, one of the comments that you made in that workshop, which was so helpful for me, was about how your systems are already producing perfectly for you. And something about that really, really landed for me, because I started then to look at how my systems are working, and seeing that they are actually giving me the results that I'm getting. And so the thought of upgrading those systems was suddenly, oh, I can do something here. So probably the main thing I've started putting in place is regularity, much more regularity. I tend to be one of these people who it's sort of got a more creative side, so I tend to flow with that.
Yeah.
And since doing that workshop, I suddenly started to think about scheduling, and now every day I do time logging. I have a sheet of paper, which actually starts at 6, although really I start at 6. Never start at 6 and go till 10. I never go till 10, but it's there. Yeah. And what that does is that means that every single day I can see, you know, just a quick note here and there about where I'm putting my energy. And then it kind of allows me to mesh in with what's actually really working for me. So just that noticing is something which has really, really made a big difference. Another thing was regular reviews. So one of the struggles I've had is working on my own, it's quite easy for me to get distracted and move off on something else. And this regular review process just helps me to adjust my course a bit more frequently and make sure that I'm actually putting my energy towards what I really want to be doing.
Yeah. Beautiful. Yeah, I love what these techniques that you highlighted, because I think especially now as we're moving into the new year, there's a new energy about being more mindful about how we use our time. And so you mentioned time logging, which it's kind of like if anybody watching this has ever done any kind of dieting or nutrition programs, you know that one of the key practices is food logging, you know, food journaling. Like you basically get mindful and you write down, what am I eating? What am I putting into my body? And just the act of awareness about what we're putting into our bodies, just even writing it down, not even making dramatic changes, just writing stuff down, that awareness creates a natural, motivation to be writing down something that's what we want to be writing down, you know? And so the same thing with time logging, you know, some people call this time awareness or time tracking, but basically, and this is something I'm so glad you're still doing it, because this is something that I did for a long time. And then I just do a kind of like 2 weeks every year. And the beginning of the year is, again, new energy, or the beginning of any quarter, really, even. It's like a new energy and new motivation to do this. So I do encourage everybody watching this, like, hey, you know, think about doing it for even just 3 days. If you try it, just kind of write down, literally keep it with you, write down every 15 minute segment, if you can, if not just every 30 or 60 minute segment of what you did during the past 15 minutes, 30 minutes, 60 minutes. And you might even start with like, okay, in the next 30 minutes, I want to do this. And then, you know, 30 minutes later, you kind of check back on what did I actually do? Oh, Facebook for 25 minutes, you know? So anyway, that's really great. And then you mentioned the daily reviews and the weekly reviews, which have been instrumental for me as well. I still keep doing it. Now, one thing before we keep going is I realized that I didn't just at least introduce you and kind of the work you do, who you are. Yeah. So let me just share that real quick. And later on, I hope everybody checks out Simon's website. He just made his new website and I'm excited about it. And it's great stuff on there. So Simon Berkowitz is, you used to be an acupuncturist, or you still are.
Still am. Yeah.
You're an acupuncturist and you're the creator of a new personal growth method called the Samai method, which is really cool. And it's designed to help people cut through their overthinking and to put them back in touch with the power, clarity, and wisdom of their inspired mind. So really cool. And when people go to their website later, you'll be able to see a lot more about that. But let's keep going on what you've been learning and how you've been growing. One of the things that you have really started to do regularly is creating content. Everyone watching this knows that I'm such a big fan of making regular content, and Simon, you've started to do that now. And maybe you can tell us why you didn't do it before and how you got yourself to start doing it now. So anything you want to say about that?
Yeah, I think there's two things. One is sort of getting some kind of way to actually get it out. And the big problem I always had before is I'd start something and then I'd get into editing too quickly. And again, this was something I'd come across it before, this idea of drafts and particularly doing three drafts. But you mentioned it, I think, again, in that same first workshop of doing that first draft, you just get it out as quick as you can. Second draft is more like editing, or at least this is how I do it. And then the third is putting a final polish. But that first one is the one I'd actually get stuck on, because I'd be in the midst of writing and I'd want to start to shape it and change it and add something in. And that kind of editing as I was going along would just cut my flow completely. And so what I found starting to write like this is that it actually meshed much more with how I do my work, which is very much about you just let things come. You follow that flow, you let that happen. And then you use that as the basis for what you're doing. And what I found with that was that it actually turned it into something a lot more fun. So I can explore as I'm going along. I can discover as I'm going along. And what's been quite helpful about that is it's given me, I suppose, an easier way of getting clear on how I feel about certain things. So it's a side benefit, really. I start writing upon a subject and I just follow the thread of it.
Yeah.
And sometimes I'm ending up somewhere completely different.
Right.
You know,
I find that all the time.
Then there's the whole shape of the thing as it comes out of you, and the structure of the thing. So something about just deciding to do it, right? Just deciding to do it, to get it out, even when it's not really feeling that great. And then you've got something to work from. And then again, coming back to the productivity bit, it's this thing of thinking about it regularly. And when we spoke yesterday, you actually even suggested daily writing, which, because I'm enjoying the writing so much, actually makes sense, because it just almost makes it into a kind of practice. So I think, you know, that thing of the drafts and then following the discovery, such a nice way to do it.
Really glad you brought that out, because sometimes people think, well, I've got one topic and I'm supposed to only just stick with that exact narrow path that I thought I was supposed to do. But I find, like you said, I find this all the time for myself. Some of the people watching this may have noticed, like, sometimes my videos aren't exactly the same as what I've written below the video or above the video, wherever you're watching this. It's like, wow, how come it's been transformed as well? And I really think of content, like you said, in terms of stages, and it's okay that it goes through stages, and it may end up a different piece of content that may be much more relevant. Who knows? But the important thing is, like you said, get it out there. Don't judge yourself. And then you can edit later. And then, you know, you can keep improving over time is what I think about it. And I'm glad you're starting to. And yes, the daily writing idea is interesting, because we were talking about this yesterday. It's ironically, it can be easier to write every day than it is to say, I'm only going to write once a week or every, you know, twice a week, because it becomes like, just like we wake up, you know, we do our morning hygiene, like everything's very regular. We don't question whether we're doing it. We just do it, you know? Yeah. And so, no, I'm glad you're doing that.
I think also the other thing about it is that it kind of, or certainly this way of doing it, it takes the pressure off. You know, before right. one of the things I would be thinking, oh, I have to get that's that right. first line to grab the attention, then I have to get the next bit to sort right. of elaborate and keep the attention, then I have to get the next bit to sort of
right.
do all the pain points and speak to it. You know, if you know, that's how the sort of marketing.
Yes, copywriting, right. yeah.
And it's just like, it becomes too much for my head to work like that. Mm. So, you know, yeah. it just feels a lot more enjoyable to be exploring the things I'm really interested in.
Yes.
Getting them out, discovering them, and then repurposing them if they're suitable. And some of them aren't, you know. Some right.
yeah. yeah.
Not for the light of day, but it doesn't.
Yeah, matter. Exactly. Yeah. One of the other things that you've been experiencing in our work together is, I mean, I guess we can call it an attitudinal shift. But maybe you can say more about that.
I think that's really to do with moving into this idea of experimenting.
Yes.
So it's rather like with the content creation. Mm-hmm. It's each time I'm writing at the moment, it's more like an experiment. And that way I get to sort of explore, yeah. find something out.
Right.
With what I want to do in the new year, which is a very short set of funnels for three different areas with, you know, Facebook ads to maybe a piece of content or a report and then a short workshop and then into a four-week program. That sort of short funnel, it feels doable. Yeah. Feels really doable for these different three different subject areas because I've got this idea of experimenting for each part.
Yeah.
And then putting it out there, seeing what comes back and letting that actually shape a little bit. So I think it's helping a bit with the kind of getting too caught up in it being the right thing.
Yes.
Because you don't know.
That's right.
You know, you really don't know until it goes out there and somebody gets a chance to engage with it. You know?
Yes.
And some of the stuff which I am very attached to and love working with for myself and works beautifully one-on-one may not translate into this kind of group format. It just right. might not work. And I won't know until it's actually out there. So
right.
I think that's the major thing is this idea of experimentation.
Yeah.
And it just takes away the pressure.
That's right.
From what?
Yeah. Right. So right on with that, you know, the idea of marketing, you know, we sometimes forget that marketing has the word market in it, and market means other people.
Yeah.
The market is not ourselves and our own ideas. The market is other people and what they think of our ideas and our yeah. product and services, right? And so marketing means engaging with other people. And the way we do that, you know, online especially, is by offering our content, not judging ourselves and then seeing how they engage and then tweaking from there. It's, oh, you want more of that? Oh, you don't, you know, you didn't respond to that? Fine, then I'll try something else, right? So I'm really glad about that. The other thing that you mentioned just as we were talking about this session was the idea of accountability and how that's been helpful for you. Do you want to say anything?
Yeah, I laugh because it's sort of the reason I came to start working with you was actually accountability. Because I find if I say to somebody, I'm going to try and do something, it becomes that much harder. You know, to get out of it. So the regularity of the sessions we've had, excuse me, and, you know, having said to you what I'm going to try and do by next time and all this sort of thing, it just ups the ante. And I think that's spread a little bit into other areas of my life. You know, it's funny, just going back to the time tracking thing, just actually putting a note in what I've been doing is a kind of accountability.
Yes. You know?
And excuse me, I'm just going to have a sip of some.
Oh yeah, water. No problem. Yeah, it's this, how whatever tools are useful for us to make ourselves more aware of where we are investing our precious life force is welcome. Yeah.
Yeah. So just getting back to actually having the sessions with you, because I know we're talking, I prepare for that. And that gets me thinking in that much more focused way, you know, because I'm actually really focusing in on what I'm really doing and what results I'm getting and yeah. if it's working
yeah.
and where I need help.
Right. Right.
You know, and all of that makes it much, much more focus. Well, I mean, it's the best word, isn't it?
That's right. Yeah. I recently wrote an article about how a lot of people kind of get sold on these big coaching programs. I mean, I'm talking coaching programs of hundreds of people or even more sometimes, you know, like the really kind of celebrity guru business coaches who sell these programs, and they make you feel like, wow, if you just go in this, you'll be successful. And then you get into it and you get lost because you're just a number among hundreds of people. And this is why I'm like, if you're going to spend $2,000 on a group coaching program, have you ever tried spending even a fraction of that on one-to-one work with somebody? Because the one-to-one work is like that person, you know, is actually hearing you directly say, okay, this is what I'm going to do, and here's where my blocks are, and then you unblock that. And then it's, so yeah, so I'm glad you brought up accountability. This is for all of you who do any kind of one-on-one work. You know, this is something you should tell your clients and talk about in your marketing. It's like the one-on-one is usually so much better for real transformation because of the accountability and focus and customized support than you could do with any kind of online course or reading a book or whatever.
Yeah. And I guess one of the things, just picking up on what you're saying, is I get to ask you a question or three or four questions.
Yes.
I get an answer then.
Yes.
You know, most of the time.
Yes.
And that's very, very helpful because, you know, you've been over a lot of these areas a lot of times. Yeah. It just saves a lot of time.
Yeah. So let's finish up the conversation and talk about what you are launching now. You know, this happened. We just talked about yesterday how you just happened to, you had a client of yours who referred you to a journalist who, you know, had just interviewed you. So you could actually get quite a bit of traffic in the coming weeks to your new website. But do you want to talk about that? And
yeah, sure. I mean, what's kind of nice about it is the synchronicity part.
Yes.
You know, that I've just sort of finished off this, you know, it's the first version of the website. I kind of like it. But it's just kind of finished. And then I get this call from a journalist, needs something quickly. I'm able to get back to her and speak on the phone. Then she was able to come for a taster. And it's quite exciting in a way. It's going to be a little piece, but it's going out to a daily paper, which has a print readership of 1.5 million. Right. So,
okay. That's more visibility than I've ever gotten. So,
right. But listen, it's a small bit. And I know from past experience, sometimes these things fly, sometimes they, you know, that nothing happens.
Yeah, sure.
Whatever. But what's so nice is just to be able to have a website, you know, which is good enough, and a message which is okay, good enough, you know.
Yes.
And you know, to be ready for the opportunities, you know. So that's coming up. And then, as I said before, in the new year, there are these other programs which we start.
So the method, the website, I should say, is www.samai.com, which is S-A-M-A-I-I. There's two I's at the end. S-A-M-A-I-I.com. So it's really great that you got the domain name, and it's the method that you created over a couple decades of doing different kinds of work and your own realizations. And do you want to say a bit about the Samai method? I mean, maybe just in a few minutes.
Yeah, I think what it is working with bodywork and acupuncture and all this sort of thing. What I see is that with people, there's this kind of moment when they start to get better. It's kind of a click or a shift or something like that. I got very interested in that. And as I worked with people, did meditation and all this sort of thing, you could see that this would happen on a non-conscious level in the person's body. And also you could see it happening sometimes in the mind. And it's that same movement that people have when they get a breakthrough. You know what happens when you get a breakthrough? You're struggling with a problem. And then suddenly you get clarity and your body feels clear, your mind feels clear, you know what you're going to do. Now, that process is what I got really interested in. How do we get into that state, right? So that's the inspired mind, effectively. Mm. We cover it up. It gets covered up by information and, you know, internet and other people and our thinking. It just gets covered up the whole time, but it's built in. And so the Samai method is all focused around how do we actually start to clear away all those habitual thinking patterns so that we can get in touch with that place and then bring it into our lives. Yeah. And if you've ever had a breakthrough, which I'm sure you have every day, dozens of times, we all do in a way. Mm. You've ever had that breakthrough moment, you know that relationships feel easier in that moment. Problems come easier. Communication, whatever it is you're working with, it's got more flow to it. So that's really what I'm interested in doing, is seeing how I can get that process more available to people so that they can have it on demand, really.
Fantastic. Yeah. Wonderful. Well, thank you for the work that you do. Yeah. I'm looking forward to more people experiencing it. And the new year, you're, like you mentioned, you're going to have a 4-week course. You'll have, I think you might have something shorter before that. And then you have 4-week course. And of course, people can contact you about working one-to-one. And given that you are just, even though you've had a lot of experience doing other things like acupuncture, you're kind of just revealing this method to the world. So right now, if anybody watching this is interested, you are accessible still at this time. So it's good. I hope people reach out if they're interested. So great. Simon, thank you so much. Anything else?
No, that's great.
Okay. Great. Awesome. Great. All right.
Thanks, George. Take care.
Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.